Okay.
You know, the grace period. The grace period is basically about to close.
Yeah, if I may add, when it says, and they shall wander from sea to sea, meaning you're going to be trying to go, you're going to be looking everywhere.
Yeah.
You know, and really, like, the sea, when you look at it spiritually, you're basically going to be trying to wander from to a place where you could draw water.
Okay.
And this is that drawing place of rivers of living water.
That's why they call it channels.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know?
Yeah, kind of.
Channels. Every channel, every great millstone channel that you go to is water just springing forth, man.
Kind.
So what you gonna do when all those channels are cut off? See? You gonna be out there and dehydrate, man, looking for water. Imagine going from apartment to apartment and trying to cut on a faucet and there's nothing running.
Kind. I got that.
Bug out, man. And that's during the time there's gonna be confusion in many places, man. Yeah, finish that MSA. Mm-hmm. Grab yours.
Okay. And they shall wander from sea to sea, and from the north even to the east. They shall run to and fro to seek the word of the Lord, and shall not find it.
Yep, the word of the Lord shall not find it.
Okay.
And keep on going.
In that day shall the fair virgins and young men faint for thirst.
Faint for thirst, man. So our people that's cast this truth behind them, when this deal goes down, man, they're like, oh, what happened to them Israelites? Because they said this was going to happen. But once that happens, you ain't going to be able to find us, man. The YouTube channel is going to be cut, you know? So you're going to be caught out there looking stupid, man. You're going to be fainting for thirst. And this word is water, man. And I got a precept on that. John 7 and 30, 37. If any man thirst, let him come unto me. No, verse 37. In the last day, that great day of the feast, Yehoshaphat stood and cried, saying, if any man thirst, let him come unto me and drink. He that believeth on me, as the scripture has said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. All right? So, hey, that's this word. It's water, man. You know? Yehoshaphat is the water. He's the light, you know?
Isaiah 24 and verse 10. The city of confusion is broken down. Every house is shut up that no man may come in.
Yeah, America, this place is the city of confusion, man. All right, in the scriptures, America is known as Great Babylon, man. All right, Babylon means confusion.
Yep.
All right, comes from the Hebrew word, babal. All right, confusion. So it's a great confusion. Go ahead.
There is a cry for wine in the streets.
Yep.
All joy is darkened, and the mirth of the land is gone.
The mirth of the land is gone. You had a taste of that in the beginning of the year, man. Or no, beginning of 2020. You know, when this coronavirus came about. You know, all the mirth of the land ceased, man.
Kind.
All right, so you know they start opening things back up little by little, and people gonna get back into that, you know, that jovial, proud mind state again.
Return to your folly.
You know, returning back into your folly. You know, niggas is going crazy down there in Atlanta and shit.
Yep.
You know, think everything's okay. All right, but that's prophesied. You people think you're going to be in good case. But wait, man, evil's going to multiply on the planet Earth, man.
That's right. I got you. Real quick. It's Luke 21. And 34, it says, and take heed to yourselves, lest at any time your hearts be overcharged with surfeiting and drunkenness and cares of this life.
Party. Man.
And so that day come upon you unawares.
The day come upon you unawares, man. So when you're in your state of folly, man, when the Lord bring this punishment, this plagues, you're gonna be caught out there, man. All right, that's hey. If you're a part of the elect, man, that day, when the day of the Lord comes, as the thief in the night, it won't catch you off guard, man. All right, because you already know you're already gonna be ready, man. All right, you are already gonna be have your garments on. You know your spiritual garments with this word. All right, you're already gonna be ready for the battle, man. All right, you're already gonna be prepared. All right.
What Sugar Free said, if you ain't gotta,
if you stay ready,
if you stay ready, you ain't gotta get ready, man.
You know, right? Yeah, we're staying ready, man. Yep. You know, we actually want these things to come.
Come.
We're hasting.
Hastening the coming of the day of the Lord, man. All right, and that day of the Lord, these plagues coming, man. You know, it's not just one 24-hour worldly day. You know, the day is expressed in 24 hours. No, the day of the Lord, you know, is wrath coming, man. You know, and that ultimate, you know, summit of the day of the Lord is these thermonuclear missiles, man. You know, and also the Lord coming back, you know, right before those missiles impact America, man. You know, that's the day of the Lord, man. All
right? It says, for as a snare shall it come on all them that dwell on the face of the whole earth.
Yep. The snare, the stumbling block. You know, our people, you know, caught up in the sports world, caught up in the entertainment world, you know, caught up in their own jobs, you know, or you know, any vice that, you know, Esau puts out there in the world, you know, our people, you know, latch on to, have their mind, you know, seared on that particular thing. You know, that's a snare unto you, man. All right?
Hey, prime example, like the brother just mentioned, Esau's in certain states, they starting to reopen up, you know, businesses, like completely. Yeah. And then they're, you know, lifting the mask mandate. So people just already figure, oh, we finna party now.
Yeah.
Esau got something on the back end of that you won't, you ain't gonna see coming.
Esau rubbing his hands like Birdman, smiling.
Shit. He finna hit you people with something hard, man.
You're kind.
The real shit. You know?
Straight up.
They gonna say it's a new variant.
Yep.
Or something.
Yeah, you got Bill Gates talking, the next pandemic is gonna be 10 times worse. Yeah. So he already said it's gonna be another pandemic. You know, 10 times worse. It's about to get real out here, man. And you people just got a taste of it last year, you know, during the start of this whole pandemic, man. You know? Anybody got something?
This is Zephaniah chapter 1 and verse 14. The great day of the Lord is near. It is near. And hasted greatly.
Yep, that's what we out here warning. The great day of the Lord is near. It's near and it hastened greatly. Right?
Even the voice of the day of the Lord, the mighty man shall cry there bitterly.
The mighty man shall cry there bitterly, man. All right, so the toughest, roughest cat, Debo, he's going to be fucking hands on his knees crying, man.
Dying.
You know? Crying for a peace of mind, man. Crying for something to eat, you know? Crying for safety.
Crying, like you said, crying for wine, crying for understanding.
Yeah.
Crying for answers.
For some sort of comfort.
Yep. Yeah.
They're gonna be comfortless.
Yeah.
That day is a day of wrath, a day of trouble and distress.
Yep.
A day of wasteness and desolation, a day of darkness and gloominess.
Day of darkness and gloominess, man. All right. Good.
A day of clouds and thick darkness. A day of the trumpet and alarm against the fenced cities.
They experienced that in Hawaii. What was that, like 2 years ago?
Yeah, kind.
Where it said Hawaii basically they underwent a nuclear threat, mm-hmm. Nuclear warning or whatever. Kind. It said nukes was about to hit the land of Hawaii.
This is not a test.
Yeah, this is not a test. You know, they had alarms going off and shit.
Okay.
You know, that's the alarms, man. Read that part again with the alarm.
John. A day of the trumpet and alarm against the fenced cities and against the high towers.
Yep.
And I will bring distress upon men that they shall walk like blind men because they have sinned against the Lord.
Yep.
And their blood shall be poured out as dust.
It said they shall walk like blind men. That's like somebody that's like for example, if you in a big ass dark room, right? Let's say you in a club, and a shooting happens in the club, but then the lights go out, so it's just pitch black.
Yeah.
What do you think the people in there doing while the lights is out, and the shots just rang out?
Right.
They're scrambling. They trying to find the nearest exit. They trying to, you know. So you people gonna be moving just like that, man. Trying to figure out what's your next move, what you gonna do to try to get out of danger, because you're gonna be in fear.
Being trampled upon and shit.
Yeah. You're gonna be terrified. You're gonna be perplexed, man.
Hey, Con. Hey, and the job of the prophet was to warn you not to go in that club.
Yeah.
Hey, but you did that shit anyways, man.
Come out of that club.
Yeah, to come out of the club.
Come out of the club.
But you went to
We held the door open for the exit.
Con.
You know what I'm saying?
Con.
We told you to come up out of the club. You see all the light out here? Come out.
Yeah.
They want to stay their ass right in that dark ass club.
Yeah.
And now shots is ringing out.
Kind.
Now the door is closed, and now you don't know where to fucking go to get out.
Kind.
You know? And people gonna be stuck, man. You know? You're gonna be trying to cry out to the idols that you seek to, and you're gonna get no answers from it, man. Because your idols is just a figment of a man's imagination from a few thousand years ago. You know?
Yeah, a lot of these idols are basically animals, you know, creatures. You're worshiping the creature and not the creator.
Okay.
They worship wood and stone.
Yep. That's made from man's hands, man.
Yep.
Yeah.
And like you niggas that's in Islam, you really think Allah's gonna have your best interest, man? When this pops off? Don't you know over there in Mecca right now, you need the damn jab to go and worship at the damn Kaaba?
Yeah, Saudi
Arabia. Allah needs you to get jabbed up for you to come and serve him? Y'all gonna be stuck, man.
Stuck in the rut. You know?
Yeah.
You can't get out. Cause the Lord don't want you to get out.
Huh?
You know? Like I said earlier about the elect, man. It's only 144,000 men in Israel. All right, 12 tribes out of every 12,000 men out of every tribe of the 12 tribes of Israel, and also the 1/3 is gonna make it out of America. All right, but in between then is gonna be great tribulation, man. All right, great tribulation. All right, so you know we're only gonna be saved by the grace of Yahweh Shem Yahshai, man.
Okay.
All right, and that's why we out here, man. We actually performing a service, man. All right, once you receive this truth, you gotta come out here and speak, man. And warn other Israelites for them to wake up.
Done.
All right.
Always.
So the blood don't be upon our own head. All right. Because it's a responsibility you have to have once you receive this knowledge.
Done.
And you know everybody. You know every brother can't be a prophet. You know, but you can be a help. You can assist the prophets. You know.
Going back to the prophet said about, that's one of our curses to eat ourselves, right? Like Deuteronomy 28:53 said that we're gonna eat ourselves. You know, that's part of our curses. So they'll eventually find out that they're Israelites.
Yeah. when they suffering the severity of the curses, you know, being upon them. I mean, we suffered the curses. We didn't went through various captivities, but the Lord's gonna make it the most intense it's ever been on us in this time. That's why it says that it's gonna be according to Daniel 12,
yeah, kind.
And Matthew 24, it's gonna be, it's gonna be like a time that has never been since there was a nation.
Yeah.
So it's gonna be worse than ancient Babylon, what happened to us then. It's gonna be worse than 70 AD, besiegement of Jerusalem with Rome, Greece, the abomination of desolation.
Right, bro.
You know, so the Lord's gonna make sure it's the worst that's ever happened to us, man.
Jake was being boiled to death. Big ass,
cauldron
pans, man.
Kind, bro. So,
yeah. You know, crucified upside down. You know, crucified, you know.
Yeah. The apostles got jacked up, like you were saying.
Yeah. Beheaded, head chopped off. Yep. You know?
Filleted.
Yeah, filleted.
Boiled.
Boiled. You know.
Stone.
Yeah. That was rough times, man. You know, but this time here, it's not gonna, those times back then, it's gonna pale in comparison to what's gonna happen here.
Yeah, I haven't admit to you.
You know, so this is how we're out here warning you, man. All right.
Okay. I'll continue on Sophonia. Back in verse 17. And I will bring distress upon men, that they shall walk like blind men, because they have sinned against the Lord.
Yeah. Well, sin, transgression of the Heavenly Father's law, that's sin. All right? Go ahead.
And their blood shall be poured out as dust, and their flesh as a dung. Neither their silver nor their gold shall be able to deliver them in the day of the Lord's wrath.
Yeah, a person's life ain't going to mean diddly squat, man. In a peaceful society, you know, so-called peaceful society, You know, one of your family members died, you got a funeral, you got the wake, you know, a couple of days later, you got the funeral, bury him, you know, but when all hell breaks loose, you're going to see dead bodies just laying out in the street, man, and you're going to be smelling that too, man. And a person's life ain't going to be worth shit, man. You know, it's going to be like dung, man. You know, you walk past a piece of shit, you know, you smell it, and you look at it, you're like, ugh, you know. But there's no value to that. It's not gonna be worth, you know.
That's why it's gonna be food for the fowls of the air,
yep.
and the beasts of the field.
Yep.
Wild beasts gonna be devouring dead bodies, birds coming down and picking at it, and
vultures
tearing the flesh out, you know.
Eating eyeballs and shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, kind.
You know?
I don't know if y'all saw the footage, but it was this one guy. He works in this I don't know if it was Amazon or it was one of them warehouses, but basically he saw the shipments of all these different body bags that was coming in, and it was damn near millions of them, you know, millions of body bags. Why are they bringing in this many body bags to the country?
Come from China.
If they're not anticipating, there's going to be a lot of bodies dropping.
It kind. It's the same thing with those big caskets that they were doing.
Yeah, them coffins.
The FEMA coffins.
Bodies hit the floor, man.
Yeah. They're planning for there to be mass death. And that's what they want anyway, right?
Yeah.
Depopulation.
Yeah.
So, hey, to a certain extent, the Lord's going to help them with that. There is going to be depopulation. It's gonna be a lot of death out here, man. Second Ezra 16 and 18. It talks about great death.
And men back then, they were stronger, man. They trained in the arts.
Yeah.
You know, Ezra's, you know, the prophets were rough, man. You know, and they were scared when they had visions of what's gonna happen here in America. You know, they're afraid, man. You know?
I'd appreciate to go what you were saying.
Because right now, man, you know, we're not used to seeing dead bodies just laying on the street, people dropping dead, you know, or people getting shot in the head, man.
Yeah.
In real life, man.
During the,
go ahead.
During the pandemic down in South America, there were bodies that was dropping, and they were just putting them literally out there on the side of the road because for the ambulance or whoever to come get them. No one was coming to get them. That's coming to America, you know?
Yeah, you're gonna see, these drones, these all gonna start, you know, dropping bombs in the ghettos, man, where these Jakes are at, man.
Yeah, gun.
They got a drone base out here, Creek, out here in Nevada, man. That they it's like a little trailer, and they got like a video game basically, you know. And they control the drones
from PlayStation.
Drop bombs on people in the Middle East, man.
Yeah.
They gonna bring that same thing here, cause Esau pushing that domestic terrorist thing, man. All right. So you know what Esau doing, you know, to terrorists, right? Yeah. You drop bombs on them. Yeah. So that's coming here, man.
Yeah. There's no technology that Esau has made that he has not weaponized.
Kind.
Literally everything that this devil has made is a weapon. He can use it any way he wants to. So if he got drones flying in the sky the size of a damn mosquito, you better believe that motherfucker got a weapon on him, man.
Yep.
It could probably release, you know, a disease, or
it could shoot,
yeah, you know, certain bullets, and it could do everything, yeah, man.
Self-destructive.
They make these little mosquito drones that can target you and just go right into your fucking brain. Yeah. They shoot at you.
They got these mosquito drones that got the vaccine inside of them.
Yeah.
And can inject you with the vaccine without your knowledge.
Okay.
Yeah.
Kind of improve,
you know, you think it's a little fly, little fly that, and you know, you doing this shit, you don't even realize you just got jacked.
Jammed up.
Yeah, man.
We tell you about Esau, man. You know, a lot of our people don't believe how diabolical this man is, man.
Kind, bro.
You know, man. and what he's capable of, man.
It tells you that in Psalms, the 64th chapter, man. They do a diligence, they accomplish a diligent search.
Okay.
The inward heart of them, yeah, the heart of them is deep.
Yeah.
You know, they look these things out, man. They search it out.
Yeah.
Okay. And they spend a lot of time and money, you know, putting it together, man. It becomes like a project to them.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know? They sleep not.
Except they have cause mischief.
Kind, that's weird. Kind.
I got something. Bring it out.
All right, this is Second Esther's chapter 5 and verse 1.
Yep.
Nevertheless, as concerning the tokens, behold.
The tokens are these prophecies, go ahead.
That they shall come, that they which dwell upon earth shall be taken in a great number.
In a great number.
Kind.
So when we say millions of bodies gonna drop, you know, in the day of the Lord, millions of bodies gonna drop.
Gone.
That's a great number of bodies, man. You know? And a lot of people, a lot of people gonna die, man. You know? A lot of people are part of the elect. They gonna get shaken up, man. You know? It ain't gonna be no cakewalk for the elect, man.
Gone.
Through much tribulation shall we enter into the kingdom of heaven.
That's right.
All right?
And the way of truth shall be hidden.
But we need to go through these plagues to reach the kingdom. So that's why we are asking the Lord to hurry up, you know, and do his thing, man. Because we gotta go through it, man. You know, ain't no way out of it, man. You know, the Christians, you know, they think that the elect is gonna be beamed up.
Yeah, pre-tribulation.
They're gonna be saved before the tribulation. No. Okay, you got Acts 14 and 22, Baba Bashar. The Christians got it wrong.
Kind.
Go ahead, bring it up.
This is Acts 14 and 22, confirming the souls of the disciples and exhorting them to continue in the faith, that we must, through much tribulation, enter into the kingdom of the Most High.
Yeah, that's what we're talking about, the tribulation, man. All right, we're talking about the family, we're talking about, you know, the nuclear destruction. All right, you know, we're talking about the people killing each other.
Yeah.
You know, every second, you know, hearing gunshots. All right, hearing bombs drop. You know, that's the tribulation that elect gotta live through, man.
Okay.
All right. Hey, but the Lord got his angels protecting the elect. All right.
and the way of truth shall be hidden, and the land shall be barren of faith. But iniquity shall be increased above that which now thou seest, mm-hmm. or that thou hast heard long ago.
The iniquity, man. The iniquity is increased. You know? Since Esau Edom got and ruled the shit, man, the last 500 years, the iniquity has been increased, man. In the last, 20 years, it's just been, just ramping up higher and higher. Just increasing rapidly, man.
Yeah, you start to see how people are starting to become more cold towards one another. Yeah. There's no more compassion. People don't show each other mercy anymore. Niggas will rob an old person in broad day. Yeah. You know, dudes will hop off of a bike and dome them, you know. Take whatever they got and hop back on their bike and get up the block.
Okay.
You know?
Grab an old lady purse and shit, knock her in the head.
Yeah.
Brick.
Yeah. People don't give a shit no more, man. That's the love of many, of many waxing cold. Yeah. Because iniquity is abounding, man.
Okay.
You see?
Yep.
So it's gonna be a hell of turmoil, man. And you Christians, you dummies. For believing that the Lord's gonna come back before the tribulation. You had one clown, and this was when brothers were responding to that Edomite, that pastor John Kilpatrick.
Yeah, kind.
When you're talking about how the Lord's gonna reimburse black people for what happened to him or whatever, and you had one dude, he got so happy that he basically said, man, there ain't gonna be no Jacob trouble. Same thing that Nate said before, which he tried to deny and say he didn't say. He said there ain't gonna be no time for Jacob's trouble. We're gonna get reparations and this and that, and nigga.
How you guys say you know I'm a Christian group? Say they Israelites.
Yeah. I don't know who this individual was. I don't think he was with IUIC, but you know, he's pretty much saying the same thing. Well, if that's the case, then why did the Lord say the days are going to have to be shortened for the elect's sake? Because the elect are going to be going through the tribulation. If the Lord doesn't reduce the time that we're going to be in trouble, none of us will make it out of it. That's why he said that. So we're definitely going to go through the trouble, man. It's the time of Jacob's trouble, man.
That's how the gold gonna be tried in the fire, man.
Huh?
I'd agree. You
know? Isaiah 40, when the enemy shall come in like a flood.
Isaiah 59.
Isaiah 59.
Yeah. How else are you gonna be proven?
Yeah.
All of his elect are gonna be proven first, man.
Yeah.
You know?
It's Matthew 7:13. Enter ye in at the straight gate, for wide is the gate, and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction.
Yeah, the word's straight. It's not, it's S-T-R-A-I-T, which means a path of difficulty.
Time, bro.
You know? That's what the straight gate is this, you know? You know, prophesying, you know? Making your body as a living sacrifice. This is the straight gate, man. You know, do that, serving the Heavenly Father, man.
Okay.
In the Son. This is a straight gate, man. And right now, we're basically like in basic training, man.
Yeah.
You know, we ain't get to the war yet, man. The war is gonna come when Jacob's trouble come, man. That's the war, you know? But, you know, the Lord is building us up, you know? The Lord is building us up, you know, getting our spirit right so we can face that, man. All right? And be deemed worthy until his return, man.
Okay.
Yep.
And many there be which go in thereat.
Many Israelites, that's why 2/3 are gonna go through that that broad way, man. All right, that broad path, man. Go ahead.
Because straight is the gate, and narrow is the way which leadeth unto life, and few there be that find it.
Few there be that find it. Can you get Jeremiah, third chapter, 14th verse.
I got the definition straight. Yep. It's from the Merriam-Webster dictionary. It says straight, a narrow channel connecting two bodies of water to a situation of difficulty or distress. Yeah. The definition of a strait is a difficulty or a hard situation. Yeah. So meaning it's not going to be easy. Most people are going to choose the easy route. That's why they're going to go in at the broad way. What is the broad way?
Taking
the easy route out, you know, saving your life. You know, instead of losing it for the Lord's sake.
Following the great multitude.
Everybody that's rushing to get this jab, they're going to the wide gate. All right, these Christians that's following these false pastors and ministers that's encouraging them to go and get the jab so they can get their life back. That you following the broad way.
Yeah.
You being shamed by Esau in the society if you refuse it, or if you talk down amongst them, or you even question it.
Yeah, kind.
Being shamed, you know. Like, how could you say that when all these people are dying? Yo, Esau's a joke, man. And 2/3 of you niggas is a joke too.
Yeah. The Lord's not gonna make it comfortable right before you go into paradise.
Right.
You're not gonna be just chilling, and then the Lord's gonna be like, all right, come up hither, and now here's the kingdom. Yeah. No, we're gonna have to prove ourselves, man. Yeah. You're gonna have to earn your way into the kingdom.
Show me your works. Show me your faith by your works. Yeah. You know, and those works are you know, like the brother said, proving yourself, showing your faith. You know, you love me. You believe in me. You believe in my name. You believe in my doctrine. Yeah. All right, prove it. All right.
Yeah. Yeah. When you're getting tempted, the Lord's gonna be right there. Of course, you know, just like you in the classroom, right? And you taking your final exam. Teacher is there, but you can't raise your hand to the teacher.
Yeah.
You can't call upon him to ask him, you know, what? No, he's there, but it's like he ain't there.
It's not an open
You
book.
On your own.
It's not an open book exam either.
Kind.
You know?
And he's gonna be looking right at you to see what, you know, what moves you're gonna be making.
How much you soaked up.
You know? Did you listen? Is that knowledge and wisdom, is it in you?
Kind.
Because that's what's gonna have to be needed in order to, you know, maneuver and get through the times that they're coming into.
And to endure to the end.
Yeah.
You know? Because that's what the Most High wants you to see, if you're going to endure to the end. Were you going to lose everything that you have, all these worldly possessions, all right, be ridiculed, be slandered in front of the whole world for my namesake, for my doctrine's sake?
Yeah.
And hey, it's already written that 144,000 men are going to pass that test. The 1/3 is going to pass that test. It's just a matter of if you were called, were you chosen?
Yeah.
Exactly. You know?
And like it says in 2 Ezra 16, then shall be known who are my chosen. Because he's gonna put them through the fire and they're gonna be tried. You know?
I got a precept. Ecclesiasticus 4:28. Strive for the truth until death, and the Lord shall fight for thee.
Done.
You know? Mm-hmm. You know, it's when this deal goes down, man, you know, it's, they're bringing back the guillotine.
Firing squads,
you know, hangings, you know. So, you know, there's going to be some martyrs that's going to die for this truth, man. You know?
Yep.
You know they're going to be the first ones that's going to be raised up.
Yep.
You know? They're going to get, at the end of the day, they're going to get the victory.
Yep.
You know? Mm-hmm. So you want to add something?
But you know, if you're gonna be a part of that, you know, being a martyr, the Lord's gonna put a spirit on you to be that martyr.
Time, bro.
So, yeah.
Yeah. Ultimately, he's gonna give all his elect. They're gonna be given the spirit of comfort to undergo their tribulation, their temptations.
Measures of faith.
You know, when we go through it, you know, you're gonna be comforted because you're gonna be thinking about the words, you know, that Yahweh Shai, you know, gave.
Yeah.
like the words that he gave his disciples before he left. You know, he said, in the world you shall have tribulation, but be of good cheer.
Now, I overcame the world.
I overcame the world. He's the author and finisher of our faith.
Yeah. He showed us how to do it.
Kind.
Yeah. And then he also told us what? When this happened, you know, don't take no thought, you know, don't meditate what you shall say. And how you gonna say it?
Yeah, for it shall be given unto
you. It's gonna be given unto you in that moment what you're gonna say.
That's right.
The Spirit is gonna be upon you, man. And even if you're one of the men that gotta go through, you know, the through death to be martyred, you're gonna have the Comforter, man. The Lord's gonna give you divine strength to be able to deal with it. Mm-hmm. Like Eleazar, like the seven Maccabees brothers, Stephen. And their mother.
Stephen.
Okay, all these different men. Antipas.
Yeah.
You're gonna eat that, and then you're gonna go to the spirit world, and you're gonna be there for a little bit, and then you're gonna come right back. You know? But you gotta be willing to strive for this unto death. And that's where the test is gonna be.
Yeah.
Are you willing to give up your life? Even if the Lord don't take it.
Yeah.
You see? A lot of these people, they, especially our people, they feel like they got a lot to live for. And you ain't even got shit.
They got a lot to lose.
Yeah. You know?
Like this job.
You've been cursed all this time. You know? You've been a slave all this time. You ain't owned nothing all this time. You know?
Yeah.
You never had a real a family and you know, substance to pass down to family.
You never got to enjoy your family.
No.
You never got to live. You never got to eat real food. You never got to just enjoy your life because you in this society, you work, and then you hopefully you can retire, then you die.
Yep.
You know, where's the joy in that? You know?
A lot of people think that is joy. You know? Having a job and working and, you know, going to college and shit. You know? Everything is fake and phony, man. There's nothing true in this land, man. Except, you know, hearing the words of the Heavenly Father, man. I got a precept. Revelation 3:10. Because thou hast kept the word of my patience, all right? Yep. What we're doing out here is keeping the word of the Lord's patience. You know, out here prophesying, teaching. I also will keep thee from the hour of temptation.
Yeah, God.
Which shall come upon all the world to try them that dwell upon the earth.
Yeah, and that hour doesn't literally mean 60 minutes.
Yeah.
It's talking about a moment of time. It, when it happens to you, that's your moment. That's your hour.
Time.
You know, when you're met with that ultimatum, when you are given a choice, it's gonna be decided right there. You know, if you're fit. It's going to be proven right then, and based on your decision, if you were really grounded and settled, if you really were made of like unto fine gold, man, that precious fine gold, man.
I was gonna say every member of the elect has their own tribulation, their own deliverance. It's going to be your you're delivered, all right. It's going to be specific to your salvation. It's going to be specific to you.
Right.
And brother ain't gonna be there to hold your hand. Your family may not be there. You're gonna be alone. You know, when the time of tribulation comes, most brothers are gonna be alone. We're not gonna be amongst brothers to have that comfort. We're gonna be, who knows where we're gonna be, but we're more likely gonna be alone. So we gotta have it in us.
And if I may add, we're gonna go through different afflictions.
Yeah.
But that main moment of temptation, that's gonna try everybody. That's it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Revelation chapter 13, verse 15. And he had power to give life unto the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak and cause that as many as would not worship the image of the beast shall be killed.
Yep. They want to X you out, man. For not worshiping and bowing down to this man's New World Order, you know, system, man. It's technocracy. his science, you know, his democracy, his LGBT and feminism. You know, that's all part of his image. He wants you to bow to that, man.
Transhumanism.
Transhumanism. If you ain't with that, he's calling you a terrorist right now.
Yep.
So he's setting the stage to get rid of you. Go ahead.
And that and he causes all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond.
So that leaves no one exempt. That leaves nobody on this earth exempt. All right? That's everyone. So that means that we all are gonna face this same thing. It might be in different days, you know, it might come a point where, you know, you might have your job that you work at. And then they're gonna be like, well, hey, you wanna continue to work here? You know, we're not giving paychecks anymore. Now you're gonna have to accept our payments through direct payments through the digital, you know, currency.
Yeah.
Which you gotta have this device implanted into.
Kind.
Everybody's gonna have to go and get this procedure done. No different than some of these jobs that are making a requirement for people to get that that JAB,
yep.
That DART. They're already experiencing that in New York already.
He starts using gradualism with this digital currency, digital system thing. Yep. So yeah, they're gonna eventually eliminate money completely. And yep. Then you're gonna have, you know, you can use your cell phone, your debit card, then they may go to a wristband, but it's gonna lead to that chip. That's what it's leading to. So like the brother was saying, your job may say, you know, you can't get the money on your debit card anymore, or they got these like little rings or wristbands. You gotta, you know, it has to be in you to get your check. So at the end of the day, yeah, brothers will have cards or phone, but at the end of the day, we're gonna draw, that's where we draw the line.
Yeah, draw the line.
We draw the line at that chip, like, hey, you know, because we still gotta survive here, but don't get it twisted. We're not, accepting Esau's New World Order with open arms. We know what time it is. We know the prophecies. We know that, you know, it's gonna come a day and a time and a place where we're going to draw the line and bail out, you know?
Hey, for some of you, your woman might get weak.
Yeah.
She might try to encourage you to get it.
Yeah.
Because you know she gonna want her life.
You got a good job. You can't quit. We got kids to feed. Yeah. We got, you know, bills to pay. You can't quit your job.
Yeah.
So you gonna have to make a choice.
Yeah. Choose the Most High of your salvation, or choose death. Just like Job's wife. You know.
Lot's wife.
Or Lot's wife. See, these are all forms of the temptations, man. It's going to be proven within that moment based on what you do.
Revelation 13 and 16. And he causes all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their foreheads. That mark of the beast, that RFID chip, man. You know, that Neuralink. You know, that's what they're testing right now. Elon Musk, he's testing that, you know, that Neuralink chip. You know, in monkeys right now, man.
Putting it in monkeys' brains so they can play video games.
Yeah.
Well, and you can see it's about to happen, man. And that no man might buy or sell, save he that had the mark or the name of the beast or the number of his name. Here is wisdom. Let him that hath understanding count the number of the beast, for it is the number of a man. And his number is 666.
So that monetary system is gonna be tied to the mark. Okay? And that mark is basically an identification number. He's gonna put his number on all the people who he deem as his slaves, his cattle,
his property.
Okay, and it's no different than when we go back to the law. If a servant was satisfied with his master,
kind.
And he loved his master. He would actually go before him and get a oil bored through his ear. And basically he would be his servant basically for the rest of his life. So if you subconsciously agree to taking this device, you allow him to get it, you know, wherever he put it in your body, it doesn't even matter. You're accepting that digital oil.
Yeah.
You know? Making yourself a digital slave to the beast.
It can, bro. It's just like, what was that, in the time of the Grecians with the ivy leaf?
You know, them getting to a Dionysus.
Kind.
And they, that was what they did to register. So you would be in the records, man.
It's like Esau has always tried to accomplish this self-tracking, you know, the tracking system where they mark their citizens, and hey, this is their last shot at it, where they think this is our final chance to get it right, you know, because they tried it in all these rulerships and it failed. All right, it did it to a degree, but it wasn't Esau's technology. Wasn't like it is now.
Exactly.
I got something else. Yep. Revelation 14:7. Saying with a loud voice, fear Yahweh and give glory to him, for the hour of his judgment is come, and worship him that made heaven and earth and the sea and the fountains of waters. And there followed another angel saying, Babylon is fallen, that great city, because she made all the nations drunk of the wine of the wrath of her fornication. And the third angel followed them, saying with a loud voice, if any man worship the beast and his image and receive his mark in his forehead or in his hand, the same shall drink of the wine of the wrath of the Most High, which is poured out without mixture into the cup of his indignation. And he shall be tormented with fire and brimstone in the presence of the holy angels and in the presence of the Lamb.
That's a severe judgment, man. That's literally the worst judgment. You know, bathing in that nuclear heat. You know, I couldn't imagine that the freaking agony. You know, it's gonna be agonizing, man. And the Lord's gonna make sure you feel that for basically betraying him. Yeah. And that's basically what you're gonna do. If you worship this beast and this you worship the image and you take his mark proudly, man, the Lord looks at you as a traitor, man. Like you're not one of his children.
Just like we were speaking of how each member of the elect has their own specific salvation. The member of the two-thirds got their own specific judgment that's to them. That where the Most High can slow down time just for you to feel every inch of that burning fire.
Yeah, the Lord controls time.
Time.
Control the time. Man.
Time, bro.
So you can feel every layer of your skin being burnt.
Time.
Hey, when you go into Zechariah, you already got it, right?
Time.
Zechariah chapter 14, verse 12. And this shall be the plague wherewith the Lord will smite all the people that have fought against Jerusalem. Their flesh shall consume away while they stand upon their feet.
So if you're still standing on your feet, that means your spirit is still in your body.
Yeah.
Woo. So you're still there while them flames is melting your shit. You're melting all the layers.
Yeah.
Bombs are still hitting you, you're standing.
Yeah, but yeah. Hey, shit, we ain't brought this out in a long time. Yeah, she was standing on her feet, right on that gate, holding on to that chain link fence. You know, hey, this is where